for managing migraine. That is especially true for your environment.
Sometimes we modify an individual's work environment, for example, right? Anti-glare screens on their computer. No fragrances in the workplace, right? Low LED lighting, or even better, green lighting, right, in the environment. Some migraine sufferers really do much better when they're able to work remotely. Why? Because they can control their own environment in their household.
If you think stress is a trigger and you practice a relaxation method like mindfulness or biofeedback or progressive muscle relaxation, you should expect to see an improvement in your headaches as you intervene. If loss of sleep is a trigger and you put sleep hygiene practices into place, you should see some improvement. So, you know, each of us is an individual, and the notion of personalized medicine applies not just to picking the right drug, but also picking your triggers and intervening on those triggers.
Some of the most incredible advances in treating migraine are still to come, and the researchers we spoke with believe that we're on the precipice of a breakthrough in this field.
Now that we have this capacity to do functional imaging, and see what areas of the brain are changing during a migraine attack, that offers enormous opportunities in terms of identifying new therapeutic targets. And so a good example of the therapeutic targets that are really exciting are these neuropeptides, CGRP, calcitonin gene-related peptide. So this is a substance that's released during a migraine attack. If you give it to a migraine patient, they'll develop a migraine. And so they have now developed therapies that target this peptide, and the enormous advantage of that is that it's highly specific. So most drugs, when you give somebody a drug, it's going to work on a variety of different mechanisms throughout the body, but this is something where we can really hone in on, you know, the very specifically a therapeutic target and go after it with an antibody.
We are finally on the cusp of having a migraine-specific preventive treatment for the first time in history, and I think that's really exciting for patients and their families, that something is really about to come onto the market for them that will help with their migraine problem.
And while we wait for new advances in treatment to become available, there are best practices that anyone can do.
When I talk to my patients, I say what we need to do is plant the seeds for success. And that's the mnemonic I give them, S-E-E-D-S. So if you have an overly sensitive brain, there are things you can do to limit your vulnerability. S stands for sleep. I want you to sleep the same amount every day. And even if you're getting up early in the morning on the weekends, don't sleep till 11 o'clock. You're gonna invariably wake up with a headache. You wanna exercise at least 30 minutes a day, aerobic exercise at least 3 days a week. The other E is eating. Not so much as what to avoid, but not to skip meals. Skipping meals is just as bad in some people as eating the wrong foods. So regular small meals over the course of the day, don't go too long without it. Drinking, water. When we talk about drinking, avoiding caffeinated beverages or limiting your caffeinated beverages to one or two a day. Avoid alcohol if that's your trigger, or limit alcohol if that's your trigger, and drink 5 to 7 glasses of water every day. I keep a bottle of water on my desk because I have migraine and I want to make sure I'm hydrated over the course of the day. The last S is for stress reduction. And again, stress reduction can be really simple, where you just close your eyes and concentrate and meditate, or you do yoga. But for some people, they really need help with it, and we'll refer them to some practitioners who will teach them biofeedback. The good news nowadays is there's so much that we have to offer people who have migraine. The first step in getting help is to get the right diagnosis. The American Migraine Foundation website has a host of information from the thought leaders talking about migraine, and there's sections that you can reach out to other people who have this disease and ask for help and see what their experiences are to guide you to get help faster, so you don't have to suffer anymore.
And I think the best thing that we do for our patients is give them hope. And the first thing we say to them is, I know you've tried a lot of things, but there's a lot more we can do. And whether we give the right dose or the right amount or the right time, other things that we can do in our inpatient program where we can actually give concentrated care. I call it breaking the cycle. We can get an awful lot of people better. And somebody who's older, you can still help them. I've had people come to me with 30, 40, 50 years of headache, and we do things, and they get better. It's not that I'm a magician. It's that we give people hope, and we tell them the following. I don't guarantee I'm going to get you better, but I guarantee I'm not going to give up. And that gives them hope for the first time in their lives.
The only reason I do what I do is so that patients can benefit. That's the only reason, that's the reason I'm sitting here today. That's what gets me up in the morning. To make an impact on a patient's life and the lives around that patient, there's nothing more gratifying.